内容主要分三个方面，第一个是工程的概况，第二呢就是施工的一些技术创新和总承包的管理创新三个方面。So
my topic will be divided into three parts: some brief introduction, then the innovation in technology, and thirdly the innovation in our general contracting management.
上海中心大厦和金茂环球组成一个比较特殊的超高层建筑群，总的建筑面积呢大约是57万平方米，高度是632米。
And you can see that together with the Jingmao and also the Shanghai World and the Financial Center, and we have seen a very special complex of super tall buildings. And the total area is around 570,000 square meters, and the total height is 632 meters.
它处在上海的这种软土地基上，采取的是钢筋混，采取的是钢筋灌注装的装法基础。
And because it is located in the Shanghai soft soil foundation, so we have introduced the board piles and the reinforced concrete rafter foundation.
上海中心的结构形式呢，是这种钢筋混凝土的核心桶以及外框锥形柱子组成的矿锥形框架结构。它采用了双层玻璃幕墙，外幕墙是一种比较独特的柔性悬挂结构体系，是个比较复杂的。
The main building adopts the structural system which consists of steel encased the reinforced concrete core, tube and mega frame. And this project also uses the double facade, and the external curtain wall adopts a very unique flexible suspended structural system.
下面呢，我就对上海中心的一些主要的关键技术呢做一个简单的介绍。
Here are some key technologies innovation.
上海中心主楼是顺着楼，采取了这种1:21米直径的无内支撑的圆形地下连续墙作为维护体系，墙身呢是50米，采取的是重型承潮机和铣陶机相结合的方式来承潮施工的。The
main building area was first structured in sequence. And the unsupported circular underground continuous wall with an inner diameter of 121 meters, which was adopted as a retaining wall for the pit. And the total depth is 50 meters, and the trenching machine and the slot milling machine were used to the construction.
我们就是采用了加强厅导墙来确保地墙的增援度。 然后整个呢就是基坑呢是，最大挖深达到33.7米，采用了就是倒分结合的方式，从四面对称开挖，然后这样的话就是成功挖土36万方米。The
construction of the diaphragm wall using the enhanced guide wall for the precise positioning, and the maximum digging depth of the foundation pit is 33.7 meters. And the excavation method of combining island excavation, and in total, 360,000 cubic meters were digged successfully.
还有一个就是上海中心采用了就是钻孔灌注桩，最大桩身呢达到86.8米。我们采用了就是厚注浆的技术，由单桩的承载力呢由原来设计的1万千牛提升到26,000千牛。
And the pile diameter of the main building is 1 meter, with a maximum pile depth of around 86 meters. And we have also used the post-grouting methodologies. And also we have made innovation for the bearing capacity of single pile. Originally it was designed 11,000 kN, and in the end it has been increased up to 26,000 kN.
另外，上海中心的混凝土施工技术呢，也不断刷新世界纪录。我们的主楼的大地板6米厚，共计6万方混凝土，我们创造了6万方大地基混凝土铺设冷却水管，一次性连续较短成功的一个记录。And
we have also hit the record high. For example, the thickness of the foundation slab on the main building is up to 6 meters, and for the concrete, in total of 60,000 cubic meters. and a new record of continuous cast of 60,000 cubic meters of mass concrete without cooling water pipe was realized in China's building industry.
我们主楼的混凝土呢，核心筒和矩形柱子都采用的是高强精密式混凝土，也全部实现了一次性泵送到顶。另外，我们2014年6月份，然后创造了C100的高强混凝土，一次性泵送到620米的世界纪录。
And also for the core cube, main buildings adopts the concrete, the C60, and also the super column, and you can see that. And we have also adopted the high strength, the self-compacting concrete, and all concrete were pumped to the top at once. And this June, and we have hit a new record high of pumping the high-strength concrete C of 100 to 620 meters just in one time.
另外，上海中心采用了就是大量使用了钢板、钢筋与钢板混凝土组合剪力墙，然后我们呢就是对这个组合剪力墙的混凝土采取了一些配合比的优化，增加了减弱剂，然后提高了混凝土的这种抗裂性能。 另外呢，我们还对这个混凝土浇导的时候，我们采取了就是分批下料，两边同时浇导的方式，然后来提高混凝土的施工质量。And
the sheer wall with a large number of liner steel plates and out-packed concrete has been used. And we have also optimized the mixture proportion. For example, we have reduced the agency for shrinkage and reduction, which can improve the crack resistance of the concrete. And when pouring in the concrete, the material was prepared at the same time on both sides of the steel plate to ensure the concrete rising at a constant speed on both sides.
另外，主楼核心筒施工的时候采取了就是液压顶升钢筋台模板，叫做体系。该体系呢，就是全程采取液压动力，然后全电脑控制同步顶升。
And we have also used our own proprietary system of hydraulic jack-up steel platform. And everything is computer-based and controlled.
钢筋台体系呢，采取了全是工具化模块化设计，然后能够应对整个核心筒的各种体型的变化。另外呢，就是钢筋台呢，也采取了封闭式的一些构造设计，然后就是。 施工呢，如同在房间里面施工，然后承载力非常大，非常也是安全，非常安全可靠的。
And we have also used the tool-based modular design for the hoisting and also the project construction. And we have also used the enclosed structural design. And in this way, the construction under the platform is both safe and reliable.
另外，上海中心采取了钢结构总用量呢，达到10万吨钢结构以上，10万吨钢结构，然后而且行价成本是多，单个的构件重量特别大，然后这种实物预拼装呢难度就周期也非常长，难度也非常大，所以说我们采取了电脑模拟预拼装的技术，然后来解决这个问题，而且精度非常高。
Yeah, because it is very challenging because the total steel consumption is over 100,000 tons, and there are also many trusses, and also for each single component, it is also pretty heavy, so that's very complicated. So we have used the computer-based simulation system for the pre-assembly.
另外，上海中心主楼结构施工的时候，负责了4台动力式大型塔吊 M1280D， 塔吊的起重能力达到2450吨米，然后自重呢达到了450吨。 我们通过就是自主设计塔吊的扶墙系统呢，实现了塔吊的整个是全部是外挂式布置。
And the whole building is equipped with 4 large whip-type tower crane M1280D, and the lifting capacity is over 2,450 TM, and its own weight is up to 450 tons, and the proprietary craning supporting system. Is an outdoor hanging system which has a very large security risk.
我们塔吊呢，随着核心筒的墙体厚度的变化呢，我们整个实现了4次超高空的整体平移，从外向核心筒方向移动了50公分，500毫米。
And with the 5 times change of the core wall thickness, the 4 times integrated transition of cranes at super high altitude was successfully realized. This is the first time.
另外，卡吊的拆除，拆除技术也是我们上面就是风险比较大的。我们这个照片上有五个步骤，基本上是先拆除南北塔吊，后面再装900塔吊，或这种后来再装380塔吊来拆900塔吊，就是这样，全部是安装在旗形钢架上。另外，在小塔吊呢，就是拆除的过程中，因为就是塔的就是拔杆比较短，所以塔吊的钢丝绳呢要全部在5区和7区要顶推出去。
And also the technology for the tower crane dismantling, this is also very challenging. And you can also see these five pictures which indicate the whole procedure. First of all, we have to dismantle the two units of MR1280D in the north and south, and then we'll set up the M900D to remove the other two MR1280D. And then we will continue to install other towers for further removal.
另外，上海中心由于它自身的结构的特点呢，我们还进行了一些施工技术、施工装备的一些创新。这个里面呢，我们以外幕墙为例，外幕墙呢是一种柔性的悬挂结构体系，全部处于凌空作业状态。外幕墙钢丝绳施工的时候，我们专门设计了，面积达到2000个平方的整体升降平台，还有就是极小转弯半径只有8米的这种，就是弯轨行走式小塔吊布置在楼层上。
And we have also made innovation upon our construction equipment and facilities. For example, the external curtain wall is a flexible suspended structure in which needs to be operated in mid-air. And during the construction of the steel supports and overall lift platform system with an area of 2,000 square meters and a walking tower crane on curved track with a minimum radius of only 8 meters was especially researched and also developed.
幕墙钢丝绳施工完成以后，就是幕墙板块安装的时候，我们又专门设计了就是可斜向发生的双层吊篮，以及利用永久的擦窗机轨道，专门设计了轨道式悬臂吊机来安装外幕墙的板块。
When the external curtain wall plate was constructed, the double hanging basket can climb at an angle and cantilever crane using the trap of the permanent window cleaning machine was researched and also developed.
另外，上海中心的外幕墙的制作系统，外幕墙设置了大量的高精度的制作，这些制作呢，就是每一个是没有在建筑工程中没有成功的使用先例，也没有成熟的配套产品。所以这些制作呢，全部是通过就是联合设计院的，然后进行定向研发的，而且在上海中心里面成功应用。
Together with other research institutes, and we have also developed the unique external curtain wall system, because it is a torsion flexible suspension structure system.Which requires a large number of high precision supports to ensure the stability and usability.
另外就是超高空重型设备的吊装，我们这时候就是随着整个结构施工、主体结构完成或者外幕墙板块已经装完的时候，一些大型的重型设备呢，这时候进去就非常困难，所以我们就专门设计了一些可移动的，就是重型机电设备的一个吊装平台，然后这个呢就是非常方便。
Because how to hoist the equipment when the structural construction is completed. Even after the installation of curtain wall, this is still very difficult. So we have developed a removable and a mobile lifting platform for the heavy mechanical and electrical equipment. And then it is very convenient and also very safe.
另外就是上海中心在125层安装了电涡流调制阻尼器，重达1000吨。所以这个电涡流系统和质量箱体系统呢是分别安装的。我们为了就是质量箱体，也专门设计了这个搁置平台和同步一个升降系统。
Yeah, the tuned mass and damper was set up on the 125th floor of the tower, And the eddy current system and also the quality casings are also installed in order to ensure the installation of damper to be very precise.
另外，上海中心的布置了18米每秒的超高速电梯，对核心筒井道的垂直度呢要求非常高。我们呢就是，钢平台施核心筒施工的时候，在钢平台上安设置了就是一些限位导向式装置，然后测量的时候呢，就是在转换层呢通过，内外控制网的连测来保证测量的一个精度。这样的话，我们现场实测，经过现在的现场实测呢。我们核心筒的垂直度单向偏差最大只有24毫米。
Yeah, because we have already seen that the high requirements of 18 meter per second ultra high speed elevator for the core tube wells and the system and the hydraulic jack-up steel platform and template scaffold for the core construction has stop block and guide. And we have also been using the segmented information transfer of surveying control points and doing the survey check at conversion layer through the surveying control network. And according to our actual measurement, the verticality of the elevator shaft has only the deviation up to 24 millimeters.
另外上，下面呢，我再介绍一下上海中心管理方面的一些做法，就是我们成立了一个专门的设计协调部来。并建立了深化设计的五大专业的设计协调平台，然后协调就是解决深化设计过程中遇到的各种问题和矛盾。
And we have also innovated our general contracting management system. We have set up a special design coordination department, and it is supposed to coordinate 5 specialties. Yeah, in this way, we can resolve any conflict during the detailed design.
在进度管理方面呢，我们建立了三级进度计划的一个监控体系，采取了合同与行政措施为主的这个资源配置机制，以及一些开绿色通道的一些就是保障措施。最终我们实现了2013年8月3号实现了主体结构580米的封顶，这比我们投标时候的这个控制节点要提前40多天。
And we have also set up the 3-layer schedule management and monitoring system. And we have also adopted the contract administration measures and also the green channels. And August 3rd last year, the 580 meters of main structures were completed. Yeah, that is more than 40 days ahead of the owner's requirement.
另外在安全管理方面，超高层施工里面，安全是第一位的。所以我们建立了安全责任分区管理制度，每个区呢都有责任人。另外，我们引入了第三方的安全责任评估，每个季度到上海中心定期和不定期的进行安全检查。引入了第三方的消防安全巡视执法队，每天在现场进行这个巡视和执法。
And the highest priority is always given to safety. So we have also set up our accountability system for the safety. And we have also introduced the third-party safety evaluation system, which we conducted on a quarterly basis. And we have also set up the third-party safety assessment patrol team, and they will conduct the inspection on a daily basis.
同时还建立了立体交叉的一些上报和公示制度，然后就是制定了这种交叉的这种技术管理方案和应急预案。
And we have also set up the cross examination system and also the reporting system.
在技术管理方面，我们对上海中心的很多超限的部分，我们就是编制了专项施工和验收的一些标准，比如外幕墙制作系统的施工及验收标准。
And we have also set up some new criteria, for example, the construction and acceptance criteria for some over-limited project. For example, the construction and acceptance criteria of external curtain wall bearing system.
另外呢，就是因为上海中心和金茂环球相邻，整个高空的风场是非常复杂的。我们建立了就是大风、台风等特殊天气下的这种长效管理机制。
And we have also conducted the long-term and also effective management system under special climate Yeah, because we are very close to another two super tall buildings, so the wind situation is rather complicated.
在质量管理方面，我们建立了全专业、全覆盖的千分之质量考证体系。
And we also establish a full coverage quality evaluation system.
对于塔吊、电梯、临时零件等这些公共资源呢，我们建立了公共资源提前申请审批机制。
And for them, we have set up the mechanism of public resources applied for the approval in advance.
并根据现场的一些实际工况呢，由总包统一的协调管理。
And the general contractor and will also make the coordination according to the actual status and progresses.
并定期的汇总和分析各单位的一个使用情况。
And on a regular basis, and we will check the usage and also the volume and the consumption.
另外就是上海中心呢，因为也建立了基于 BIM 技术的一个协调管理体系。
And the BIM-based coordination and management system is also set up.
总包呢成立 BIM 工作室，然后各个专业呢各个分包呢成立这个 BIM 工作团队，就是然后进行在总包的协调下呢，与各个专业呢进行合谋，进行这个碰撞检查，上下协调。
And for our general contractor, we have set up the BIM office, and for each specialty, and they have also set up their own BIM working team in order to have a better coordination.
这是建立的一些整体一些模型。另外呢，上海中心呢也采取了一些现代化的管理手段，建立了一些基于网格化、工程化、信息化的这种工程管理系统。
State-of-the-art and technology are used, so we have set up the coordination and management system based on the grid and information-based technologies.
同时还建立了基于现代物流管理系统的这种，就是施工材料的施工材料的物流化管理系统，实现了大众施工材料呢能够按照现场的需求定时定量的运送到现场。
We have also set up the modern logistics management system, and the supply of construction and building materials can be made on demand.